Adam, thanks for coming in again.
No problems.
We're making pasta today and sure we've got something a little bit different.
Yeah, we're going to use pasta as a secondary component to this dish. So it's just use it in different light and manner, do you know what I mean? So we're going to do crispy skin salmon.
Yep.
And we're going to do a rocket and almond pesto with tagliatelle. Yep. And then to finish on top, I want something nice and refreshing, some Greek-style yogurt peppered. So we'll get into that a little bit after.
Okay.
First and foremost, we'll go to this one quickly.
Yeah, okay, explain, so, I'll wait.
Look, we've got the salmon there.
Yep.
All I'm going to do is just get you to score the skin just a little bit for me.
Okay.
Right?
Yep, I can do that.
And we're going to get that really pan nice and hot so we get really super crisp skin on it. And basically all we'll do is going to cook for 3 to 4 minutes on the skin. Look at that. That's fine. Look, it just stops it from obviously just
curling
up. Yeah, and it was keeping a nice little flat base of that fish. Beautiful. Now, with the pesto, look, if you don't like almond, you know, you could substitute to walnuts or you could go pistachio if you really wanted to, but I just find that the rocket and the actual almond work really well together. And we've got blanched almonds as well. So into the pesto. Fresh rocket.
Okay, so a handful?
Yeah, you got a handful. And look, you can make this rocket and keep it in your fridge. Get a little jar, keep it in the fridge, you know, have that pesto sitting there for whatever you want to do, you know?
Yeah.
Just a little bit more olive oil to the pan, just a touch. Stop it from sticking. All right. Almonds into there as well.
Yep.
One clove of garlic. So skin side down, obviously, to get that nice crisp skin. What I do, look, see, starting to kill, but because you've made those scores in there, it stopped flat.
Yep.
Beautiful. And remember, with the actual heat of the pan, it's like resting a piece of meat after. We'll cook it to that medium rare stage, but because of the heat within the pan and the fish, it's going to keep on cooking through.
Mm.
So, you know, don't be scared to undercook it a little bit, and especially with salmon needs to be, you know.
And fish is delicate, so, you know, it is going to keep cooking.
It is. The San Remo tagliatelle, obviously in the little nests, right? And I work on about one nest, two nests to an entree, and three for a main course type of sizes.
Per
Per person. Yep. But obviously we've got the salmon with this. So we're going to put a whole packet in there. Here we go.
So I'm going to give that a first blend and then we're going to add some olive oil, salt and pepper.
Give that a little blitz. Beautiful.
Okay.
So get some olive oil.
Salt and olive oil.
Yeah, some parmesan into there as well.
Parmesan, that's what I forgot. So about a handful.
Good handful. You know, the parmesan works together so it binds it all together obviously with the olive oil.
Yep.
And then that cheese with the pasta just works fantastic.
Really works.
Does really well. Look, if you're a fan, you know, not a big fan of parmesan or cheese in general, you could eliminate it, but I just believe, you know, a pesto without cheese just doesn't really make sense.
Unheard of.
Or you could make a salsa verde. So salsa verde is, you know, different all again. So, Look at that skin.
Ooh.
Really
nice
starting to crispen up.
Yep.
So we're just going to leave it there. It's doing quite well. Beautiful. Some more olive oil to that. Don't be shy. Olive oil.
Say when.
Stop. Would be great. So look, those nests, Justine, have just basically unraveled themselves in the water. And that's only going to take about 8 minutes to cook.
Do you have a taste?
Just a little taste, see if it needs some more seasoning, some salt or some pepper. That fresh pepper should be there from the rocket alone.
Honestly, it doesn't need pepper. Pepper him.
Yeah, that's exactly
right. I like it has a bit of crunch to it.
Yeah.
And using, when you're making pesto, using good quality extra virgin olive oil makes a difference, doesn't it? Because you can taste it through it.
Alrighty, so with our, obviously with our salmon I spoke about before, a peppered yogurt. So I like using the Greek style yogurt. It's a little bit more thicker. Take a couple of tablespoons of that into a bowl for me.
Yes.
Then we'll get our white ground white pepper there, the Mackenzie's, into there as well.
Yep.
Got some Szechuan pepper as well, so the Chinese pepper.
Okay.
And basically that's really big. That's, you know, and what I find with the Szechuan, it's big on the back palate. And then some just simple cracked black pepper also.
Yep.
Yeah, so a good pinch again.
Good pinch.
Give that a mix.
Yep.
And away we go.
Have I put enough in there?
Yeah, look, we'll try it and see how much, you know, how much peppery taste we're getting through there. Look, we flip them over there, and look, that's perfect where we need to be. So I've turned the heat off on that totally now.
Yep.
So there's enough heat within there to keep cooking those pieces of salmon.
Just to finish it
All I've done is lift up that tail end a little bit there,
just
so the thicker end keeps on cooking through.
It's a good little tip.
Pasta's almost there, so I'll get you to grab the pot, we'll strain it.
Okay.
What we do with the pasta, when it straight away comes out of the water, we're going to just basically drain it off, then we're going to get the pesto and just lightly coat it through.
Okay.
So al dente, we're already there. And here we get.
I love tagliatelle.
Yeah, the egg noodle is fantastic.
Very nice,
It's really nice. And, you know, I find with the egg noodle, especially San Remo tagliatelle, it's nice and light and, you know, you can eat a nice big plate of it and not feel too, you know, bloated.
Yeah,
really
exactly,
good. make sure we strain off most of that water from the pasta.
Yeah, we'll get that rid of that out of your way.
Yep.
Teamwork.
That's the way. So look, be gentle with it.
Yep.
Just place it into the bowl. Look at those ribbons.
Lovely.
Yeah, all of that. Take that there. So I'll get you to grab up the plates now. We're not too far, but it's really simple. Look, next couple steps.
Nice, fast dish.
Get in the pesto. Get a nice little ball. Get onto the plate there like so. Mm. Look, you go a little bit larger if you're really hungry.
I love how you do that, little nest.
Doesn't always work out, you know? So what I might get you to do, Justine, grab a lemon and just cut two little cheeks off to serve with this, just behind us. So we'll get our salmon straight onto, just sit up against there like so. Perfectly cooked.
That's good.
Now, just a little cheek each. Then our peppered yogurt, just to finish. Look, you could smear it on the side if you're not interested in liking it.
Yeah.
A little bit over the top, like so.
I mean, look, everything, it's just restaurant quality, but you can do this at home.
Exactly right. And look, it doesn't take much time. And look, if you're not into fish, maybe you could do a nice little piece of scotch fillet or something like that in your pan. Exact same processes.
Chicken, yeah. Like, but I love that. It looks fantastic. It really does, and it takes hardly any time to do.
Minimal
time. Interesting flavours. Love it. Thank you.
No worries. Let's get into it.